tensions building. All around, you can feel it in the air. It's more than a feeling, a new reality everywhere. I look to see the signs of the times. Yeah, it's coming, but they're all in denial. Everything you know, it's all about to change. See the sky crack and it rains down flames. Oh man, they ain't ready for it. This is something that they can't ignore. Coming down like a meteor. This is more than a game, you better get ready. Shock the world.
Shock the world.
Shock the world.
Shock the world.
This is more than a game, you better get ready. Go ahead, get ready. Shock the world.
Shock the world.
Shock the world. Reality became unchained, like the jaws of a lion that can't be tamed. Welcome to the future, everything new. Walking on the edge, it's nothing that you used to. Only the strong survive, you better catch your breath. Oh man, they ain't ready for it. This is something that they can't ignore. Coming down like a meteor. This is more than a game, you better get ready. Shock the world.
All right, welcome in here in Plano, Texas. It's game number 8 for Team Arizona in total. Team Black, their fourth game as they move in to round robin play. Playoffs begin tomorrow, de facto playoffs, as we'll see where they seed and where that figures out. Team Copper fell 2-1 earlier tonight to a very good Team Texas team. It was a great game back and forth, and potentially we could see that team in terms of Team Texas tomorrow in terms of the 1-2 game in the Dallas division, which is the higher division here at the Lone Star Showcase in Dallas. Team DMV, which I've gotten a lot of questions about in the last few days. Where's DMV? We've had Team Idaho, Team Texas. Where's Team DMV? Well, it's DC, Maryland, and Virginia. So a combination of those three states. They wear the red, very similar to the Washington Capitals, you could say. Team Arizona Black in their black jerseys with the red on the shoulders. They found their way to a 6-3 win earlier today. Got their first win. Now they're 1-1-1 in the first three games. They'll look to move up to 2-1-1 against a Team DMV team that is run roughshod over the Fort Worth division. They're known as one of the stronger teams in this division. We'll see what they come out with. It'll be Wolf, Brown, and Payne, which has been the top line for this Team AZ Black team in the first three games. Wolf had 3 goals in the earlier game this morning at 8:45. Both teams ready to go in our final game here on Saturday, our fourth game for Team Arizona, whether it be copper or black. Let's finish it off here late in Plano, Texas. Wolf on the forecheck will go right on after it. Payne backhands it forward, It comes right back out to neutral. DMV over the line. It's Patenti to the side of the net. As it goes off the post, a quick post shot on a 25 seconds in. It's Roy Moen in net for Team Aries E Black. He went 8-for-8 in game one. They split the game, him and Chance Taylor. Taylor will get the second half of the game tonight. Off the skate of Payne, picked up. Now they're going to try the alley-oop pass to Wolf. He catches up to it. Sharp angle shot, save, rebound try, and Brown came down in front. Payne tried to bat it out of midair, but had to wait for it. A good start to the game for both sides. Iron hit on one end. Now DMV the other way. Right in the middle is Patenti as Moen makes the save and will cover just 1:02 in. It might be a little late here in Texas, coming up on 10 o'clock, but the pace has been really good in both games. Texas took down the Copper team 2-1 in a game that had a good amount of penalties in the first few periods, but in that third period was a classic, coming all the way down to the last few seconds. At the blue line, it's Valco. Shot from up high, goes wide. Valco will come and pinch in. He chops at it. It bounces up at the blue line. Nice stick handling by Repke. He'll step in, shoot, and Moen with the save. Now, Roy Moen, throughout his Horizon High School career, only had 1 year as a senior. He started in Wisconsin. That's where he was since he was two. Played in the Appleton, Wisconsin area, and then moved to Arizona, back to Arizona where he started, or I should say where he was born, for his senior year. And he really thrives when he gets more rubber on him. That's why a team DMV shot, as Moen catches another, could prove very well for Moen. He's used to 40, 45, sometimes even 50 shots. We did a game earlier this year. He played against the Pinnacle Pioneers, a top three seed in D1 this year, at the start of the year at least, and made over 50 saves in a very close game as Pinnacle came out on top. Valco tipped in front, went wide. That was Repke at the side of the net. He got a piece, but it went wide of the glove side of Moen. Back behind the net, wraparound try in front, they score! Just 1:51 in. Team DMV takes a 1-0 lead on a pass right in front. And Esko Himmelfarb puts it in the back of the net. Fourth shot on net goes in the back of it. 1-0 DC, Maryland, and Virginia. Himmelfarb gets the goal. We'll see who gets the assists. On a goal that Moen had no chance in front of. Himmelfarb was wide open in the slot. He deposits it in the back of the net. Castellucci in net for Team DMV has made one save so far. The 0-7 from Springfield, Virginia. Spice back in his own end. Gets it up to Black, who crosses the line, steps in, he shoots, it goes off a shin pad. Jumps down to Barnett, tries to wrap it around. Wade goes off the glass, and it goes out of play. So a quick start for Team DMV, and for Team Black, who's played two very close games yesterday. They lost 3-2 early to Team Midwest early yesterday, and then they lost in the shootout, which goes down as a tie here in the Lone Star Showcase. 2-1 to Team Idaho in the late game yesterday. They get their first win this morning. As the tip in front, one more try, and they score again. Under a minute, two goals for Team DMV on two chances right in front. Back-to-back shots, back-to-back goals, and this time it's Carter Foss who went from his forehand to his backhand. Moen was going right to left, and Foss goes from right to left to put it in the back of the net on the backhand. Team DMV up 2-0. Two goals in under a minute, and now a lot of pressure here on Team Black as they put it right back in front again, still loose. Moen down in the butterfly. It goes to the corner. Backhanded forward by Repke. Along the wall, Landon Wood with his Notre Dame prep helmet the gold gloves as well. Gets it back to the rival Pinnacle in Derryberry. Now Pinnacle Minthorn to Notre Dame Wood. Backhand to the head. Derryberry holds it with the skate. Wood takes a hit from Tollett. And Spencer will hold it back. Derryberry pinches up to try to keep it in. Spice back. Team DMV just moving at a little bit of a faster speed right now to start off this one. Derryberry back, gets it up to Wood. Strong breakout pass for Minthorn. Puts it into the corner. Peretti takes it away. Peretti across the line. His shot went over the net. Spencer on the rebound, puts in the slot. Sticks go flying, and the puck comes out to Team Black. Wolf will tip it ahead. Back is Cimino for Peretti. Centering pass taken away by Connor Brown. See if they can get it to Wolf. The long stretch pass has been the name of the game on offense for this line that has been so good for Team Black today. Brown backhands it off the wall. It goes past Jensen. Brown puts it on the far side and goes and gets it. Watched closely by Patenti. Brown dodges a check. Castellucci sticks it right down deep. Brown back to the blue. Shot goes wide. Wolf will go and chase after it. Picked up and moved out by Team DMV in the red. We're going to have a penalty upcoming. It's going to go against Team DMV for interference. Connor Brown drew it. It was right at the center of the ice. The officials giving Giancarlo Cimino from Edgewood, Maryland, a little talking to. What did he do wrong? What can he do better next time? He's headed to the box. First time to the power play for Team AZ Black. An opportunity that they really want to make good on. Quickly down 2-0. You want to cut that in half and get your offense going against a very heavy offensive team in Team DMV. Tobin goes back for it. Tries the far side, kept in by Derryberry. Three forwards, 2D for Team Black on their power play. Burr and Derryberry at the top. Blake Burr kept it in, looking for Wolf. It hit Payne in the center of the ice and picked up on the shorthanded chance by Clavin. Clavin pass one, Clavin shorthanded, and a blocker saved by Moen. 5 minutes into period number one, 30 seconds into the power play. Patenti trying to hold it right in front of the Team AZ bench. Blake Burr will go to the corner. Pressure, even shorthanded. Here by Patenti, takes it away. Centering pass. Goes off a stick. Here's Wolf. Wolf with Payne entering on the near side wing. Payne across, looking for Brown. The pass went behind him. Patenti with the pressure. Now Jensen the other way. Good stick, as getting in the play was Ethan Glantz. Stopped an odd man rush. Cross-ice pass, picked off. Tobin the other way. Breakaway pass for Jensen. Jensen to the backhand, taken away by Glantz. 45 seconds to go in the man advantage. 6-1, Team DMV leads in shots. Payne looking for Brown. Pinned the boards by Spice. Esko Himmelfarb as well. Tesmer shoots and a save by Castellucci. His first real test of the day. Brandon Tesmer has not been afraid to shoot the puck in this tournament. And why not with how hard of a shot he does have? So an offensive zone draw, 28 seconds to go in the man advantage for Team Black. Team DMV 2-0 with a game that went to overtime. So far, they have not lost in regulation. Barnes on the half wall. Down low for Schaefer. Schaefer had a goal earlier today. Finished off a 6-3 win for Team Black. Schaefer lost the puck. Still loose in center. Repke applying the pressure. Barnes with just a couple ticks left on the man advantage. And out of the box comes Cimino. A successful PK for Team DMV, allowing just one shot on net. that Castellucci had no problem with. Repke across the line from the backhand of the forehand, saved by Moen. Rebound chance, still loose. Moen down in the butterfly and cleared out by Team Black. Schaefer turns it over. Patenti steps into it, onside play. Patenti to the net. Patenti shoots, saved by Moen as he stuck with the forehand. Roy Moen quickly under halfway through the first period. He already has six saves on eight shots. Team DMB taking it to him. A lot of speed. They play well in the neutral zone. They force turnovers. That's what we've seen in the first 6 minutes. Patenti waits. He shoots. It went over the net. Karam's on to the far side where Brown plays it across. Becker knocks it in. Brown can't hold it along the wall. DMB comes out the other way. Pass across to Barnett. This play is offside, as Black was cutting down the center of the ice, and he was too early. Just around the midway mark through the first. Team DMB with two goals in the first 3 minutes, and they came under a minute within each other. Barnett at neutral to Black across the line. Black shoots, blocker saved by Moen. He gets past Burr. Becker applies the pressure. Centering pass went behind the net. Becker takes his man out. Brown comes out along the far side and he'll whip it in. Castellucci plays it with his big goalie stick. Landon Wood can't keep it in. Barnett the other way with speed. At the 7 minute mark, Barnett taken off the puck by Burr. Side of the net, pass through the crease, nobody home. Spencer on the far side corner. Gets it to Black. They start the cycle. Down low, Spencer. Trying to get it to the half wall, and they do, but turns it over to Brown, who gets it back out to the red line. DMV looking for it one more time. Spencer tips it in. Patenti will step up on Wood at the end of a long shift. He puts it into the stick of Walker. Talent on the near side with some room. Off of his stick, off of his glove, and off the netting. Talent takes a spill after he took a hit from the defenseman Derryberry. In this Fort Worth division, there's only two teams without a loss. Team Idaho is 3-0. Team Midwest is currently at the top because they've played the most games. They're 3-1. So if Team DMV wins this one, they will move to 3-0-0-1. They lost in overtime or a shootout. That's the ruling, but they will be placed atop the division with 10 points if they come out with a win. They'll be the number one seed. Pass in front, loose puck. Oh, it didn't go in the back. Tobin came back to deny Wolf as he was wide open at the side of the net on a fortunate bounce. Cable toward the net, pad save, and into the netting. First big chance for Team Arizona as Cable was at the side of the net and Tobin just left his stick at the last moment. Weissman, Cable, and Levake, the three-man forward unit with Glantz and Wade on the back. Cable pushes off the draw. Bodies go flying, and out comes the puck with Team DMV. Masick gets hit by Wade. Laid him out, and the Team Arizona bench loves it as Moen's going to cover. The physicality's picking up, some frustration here from both sides. And now 9 saves already for Roy Moen with 5:37 to go in period number one. Scheinerman in the circle against Cable. Still loose in the circle, loose puck, they score, it goes in the back of the net. Patenti wide open in the slot. Goes over the blocker of Moen and in the back of the net. It went in and out in a snap. And the third goal on the board for Team DMV. Patenti makes it 3-0. 3 goals in under 8 minutes for Team DMV, and that one, Roy Moen had no chance on. Patenti has a 6 shot, puts it right over the blocker. He was wide open in the slot on a fortunate bounce. Spice goes across, looking for the centering pass. It goes to Nick Wolf. Here's Wolf all the way across, looking for Payne. It goes off the glass. Payne in neutral. Loose puck moving in. Pass across was blocked down by Glance. He got down on the 2-on-1. Brown off the boards to Payne. Across for Wolf. Wolf had 3 early this morning. He had the hat trick. Now just looking to get on the board is Team Black. Payne is spun around by Spice. Now Brown goes flying as he lost an edge. Scheinerman across the line on the near side. His drop pass for Jackson, whose shot went off the pad. Jensen comes in on the forecheck. Back behind Moen. Brown comes back below the goal line and will high flip it out on the backhand. Loose puck, Wolf, at the end of a long shift, will carry. Over the line, drop pass for Payne. Payne walks in, drop door, it goes off Pontetti and in. A fortunate bounce for Team Arizona as Payne put it in front, off of Peretti, and into the back of the net. Payne will get credit for it. The old phrase of throw every puck you can toward the net proves true there. As a fortunate bounce goes through Castellucci's legs and puts Arizona on the board 3-1. So Payne breaks the ice. And this one goes down for icing. They'll give Brown and Wolf the assist. That top line continues to roll here in Dallas. Minthorn backhands it behind him on the draw. Peretti gets some help with Calvin. Clavin for Esko Himmelfarb. Down low, back in front. And Repke couldn't get his stick on the ice. Peretti tried to keep, got it past Barnes. Nice move at neutral by Himmelfarb. Long range shot, it goes in! Just as Team Arizona gets on the board, Team DMV comes right back. Himmelfarb with his 2nd in the period to make it 4-1. He had the 1st goal and now he gets goal number 4. On a long range shot from the top of the circle, he puts it past the blocker of Moen and in the back of the net on the short side. Moen was perfect this morning, 8 for 8. So far, 9 for 13, and not all of it has been his fault. This is a top-tier DMV team that puts a lot of pucks toward the net. Faceoff will be in neutral, 13-5. DMV leads in the shot total. Black and Payne meet up in the circle. Under a minute after Payne scores, Himmelfarb comes right back and gives Team DMV a 3-goal lead that they gave up for less than a minute. Calvin goes down. No arms up as Derry Berry's in the corner. He tips it ahead. Walker puts it across. Brown back on D. Got a piece of that shot from the blue line, and Moen did as well with the left pad. Back in front, another right pad save. Moen showing off the pads here in that shift. Wolf across the line. Nice pass to Brown. One more pass for Payne. And it got taken off the stick by Valco. Valco played that 2-on-1 very well as he got the stick in the way and didn't allow Payne to have an easy touch pass goal. 2:30 to go in a first period that's had 5 goals and a lot of puck possession from Team DMV. They move quick, they pass quick, and they make their decisions even quicker. Once the puck is heading towards one, they know where it's going after that. Wolf to Payne. Gets it ahead, looking for Minthorne, picked off by Talant. Talant over the line, looking to get past Glantz at the goal line. He'll circle the zone, back in front, off a stick. Back to the blue. Shot didn't go all the way through by Spice. He gets his own rebound. Minthorne's clearing attempt, gets it up to Barnes. Barnes with a little bit of time and space now over the line. Castellucci will stick it into the netting and get a whistle. Team Black has played a one-goal game, a game that really ended up as a tie before the shootout, and then a three-goal victory this morning. This one on the other side of things. Minthorne wins it back. Schaefer's shot goes wide of the blocker side. It hits off the back glass. Caroms all the way out to O'Sullivan. And now Talant goes the other way. His shot into the catching mitt of Moen, and he'll cover. This team DMV team, they come down. They know they want to put the puck on net. And that's what the scouting report says. They love to put the puck near the netminder, no matter who they're playing. 16 shots already here in the first period. Spencer back behind the net for Minthorne, who pins his man to the boards. Schaefer tips it ahead as the defenseman went toward the wall. And this will be an icing as Peretti is the first man back. .118 to go in a period that Team Black is going to want to forget. One that they hopefully can wipe off in the 1 minute intermission before the second period begins. There's no ice cut between any periods here at the Lone Star Showcase. And we thank you all for tuning in here on the OSHA YouTube page. A big shout out to our producer, Ben Smith. Without him, none of this would happen. He's the reason we're on the air. And here's Becker on the breakaway. Becker, and a big save from Castellucci. Gets his glove in the way, and the first real test for him. The goal went in off Payne. An unfortunate bounce off of Peretti of Team DMV. Other than that, Castellucci has been stellar. Under a minute to go in period number one. Burr, long pass, looking for Payne off of his stick. Becker picks it up, gives it back for Tesmer, who tipped it forward. Valco across to Tobin. Off the wall, Becker tried to lay his man out. And Scheinerman just skated right past, and he puts it in the back of the net. With 21 seconds to go here in the first, Scheinerman makes it goal number five for Team DMV. You never want to give up a goal in the first or the last minute of a period. Well, Team DMV started early in the first 2 minutes, 1:51 in. And they also score with 21 seconds to go in the period. 5-1, Team DMV in front. Valco will backhand it across. Back in front looking for Weissman. Cable was there as well. Last chance rush for Team DMV. Backhanded to neutral. Levesque will hold, and that will take us to the end of period number one. 5-1, Team DMV in front with 17 shots on goal. Team Arizona with 7, the one goal from Brody Payne. We'll be right back for period number two. back here for period number two in Plano, Texas. Just about 20 minutes north of Dallas. Team AZ Black with a period that they like to forget. Giving up 5 goals on 17 shots. Getting 7 of their own, and the only goal they got was a shot from Payne that went in off the defender of Team DMV. And they're pumped up as they bang their 6 against the glass, or checked out the boards, and get ready for period number 2. Clavin back, it's period number 2 off and running. Period of the long change. Payne, it pops up in the air off of him. Kessmer will go back, and Moen will cover. We talked about Moen earlier, played 1 year of high school hockey in Arizona with Horizon this past year. Had a few really good games. The numbers don't tell the entire story, as Horizon had a little bit of a down year, but Moen was still excellent in net. It wasn't a gimme, as he makes the first save, another save, and then dives to get a piece of the shot on the backhand by Clavin. Brown ahead for Wolf. Across the red, he'll swing it in. Spice at the half wall. Payne can't hold on to it. Wolf applying the pressure as Esko Himmelfarb tried to move it in. This play is offside, as Himmelfarb wasn't out of the zone just yet. And he already has 2 in the first period. They're going to put the puck on the faceoff right back to neutral. With these intermissions being only 1 minute, it's a pro and a con. Especially when you have a period that you're not happy with, like Team Arizona just did. It's a wipe it clean really quick. You don't have to reflect on it. You don't have to think about it for 15 minutes. Now they're going to move it all the way back. They're going to say this was delayed off or offsides on purpose, intentionally. Which gives Team Arizona an offensive zone draw. Depending on seeding and records in this Lone Star Showcase, we'll see what time and where, as the loose puck pops out to Barnes and a good save from Castellucci. Barnes leans back, wishing he got a better piece of that shot. On a good chance on the 8th shot on goal for Team Black. Depending on wins, losses, points, and all that jazz, make sure to check our social medias, Asha_hockey on Instagram, Twitter, and Facebook, to see when each team will be playing. Each team will play at least one, well, they will play one game tomorrow, each team, Team Black and Team Copper. It's just a matter of when and where, and like I said, if we can stream it, and I mean if, as in both teams don't play at the same time. It's the only reason we didn't stream the Team Black game against Idaho yesterday, because we were over at the other rink, the Farmers Branch rink, to stream the Team Copper game against California. After the whistle, Barnes gets knocked down by Peretti. Some words being exchanged, and this is what happens when frustration boils over from both sides. They're going to send Barnes to the box. We'll see if anyone from Team DMV does. Barnes is going to get the roughing call. And that was after the play. So Barnes to the box. He sits in there. And a penalty against him for roughing. If you can believe it, it's the first penalty of the game. Team DMV scored all 5 in the first. I checked that first penalty against Team Arizona. They went 0-for-1 on the power play earlier in the first period. This is the first time they go to the PK. All 5 goals in the first period from Team DMV were of the even strength variety. And now they have a man up. Glantz goes back, puts it off the wall, shorthanded Schaefer. Schaefer and Minthorn are 2-on-1. Schaefer goes to the outside, tried to feed Minthorn in front, and it didn't connect. Cimino the other way for Team DMV. Schaefer gets the loose puck and whips it in, where Castellucci will stop it for Cimino. 25 seconds gone in the man advantage for Team DMV. Looking to move their undefeated record to 3-0-1 on this showcase, moving into their one game tomorrow. Cimino steps up. It's a 2-1-0 the other way. Minthorne's all alone. Minthorne shorthanded. Minthorne backhand tries on the goal line and taken out of midair. Somehow Barnett got back to take it out from the goal line. We're going to have another penalty. It's a kneeing call, and it's against Team Arizona. Schaefer will head to the box. From such a promising opportunity, let's see another look at that. Minthorne cutting in, went to the backhand. It sat right at the goal line, and Barnett took it right off. Unfortunate for Minthorne and Team Arizona. Well, from that chance one way to now a 5-on-3 power play for Team DMV. Right off the draw, Burb clears it all the way down. Schaefer in the box for kneeing. 2.5 gone here in period number 2. Tobin across the line on the forehand. Goes past O'Sullivan. Back at the top, Valco. Gets it back to Tobin, who sets it up at the top of the zone. Cable watches them closely. Valco at the circle, way across, and the shot went off the side of the stick of Sarda. Sarda back to Tobin. Winds it up and shoots in a glove save by Moen. 5-on-3 for 25 seconds more before Barnes will come out of the box. There is no mistake on what's being told on the bench. What's the strategy of Team DMV? It's called getting pucks to the net and getting high danger, high quality shots on net as well. Across to Valco in the circle, Tobin at the top. He'll hold and give it back to his winger on the right side. He switches with Talant. Back to Valco. And now Talant all the way across for Sarda off of his stick. Burr watches him. Valco was trying to drop it. He was open in the slot. Couldn't get the shot away. 5-on-4. Rebound chance. Still loose. And Spencer couldn't put it in on the easy far side. He had a tap in on the power play. He couldn't finish the job. Moen gets a piece of this one. It pops over the net. Burr goes off the wall. Talant in front. Spencer's all alone. And a blocker save by Moen. Maybe his best of the night so far. Cleared out by Minthorne and Weissman. But not passed. Spencer drops it. Talant. One more try. Moen save. Rebound score. Power play goal for Hudson Spencer. Team DMV now up 5. Team Arizona killed out the 5-on-3, and Moen made the first save, but no chance he could make 2. Spencer makes it 6-1. What's so impressive, as now Chance Taylor is going to come in net for Team AZ. Taylor had a very good start to game 1 this morning. He went 9-for-10, and a lot of those shots, maybe 7 or 8 of those shots that he saves, were high danger chances. Spencer gets goal number 6. What's so impressive with Team DMV is not only do they put so many pucks on net, they have 25 shots on goal, and we're not even 5 minutes into the second period. But they get it from up and down their lineup. 2 goals from Himmelfarb, but 6 goals and 5 different scores as Cable put it high. It's very impressive. And they're not all on the same line either. Becker lays a hit. Cable flips it in. Icing waved off. Coming back to get it is Masick. He'll drop it for Spice. Spice taken down. No arms go up. Last thing Team Arizona needs is taking another penalty. It was a power play goal for Spencer. This one first saved by Taylor, and he's touched up after the play. Tesmer pushes away the incoming forward in Scheinerman as Chance Taylor gets his first save. Moen saw 25 shots. He saved 19. Faceoff will be to the left of Taylor. Tesmer goes down deep. One for two, officially for Team DMV on the power play because they had two chances. Did not score on the 5-on-3, scored on the 5-on-4. Tesmer just misses the netting to get it out. Himmelfarb comes back, dangerously plays it in front of his own net, turns it over to Brown. Brown for Wolf. He drags, looking back door. Wolf has such a great shot. 21 goals this season in high school in 20 games. But didn't take that one. Looked for the extra pass. And Payne, well, just didn't make it to him. The stick got in the way. Cleveland lays out Tesmer right at his own blue line. Wolf is offside. Hindsight's always 20-20. If you're Nick Wolf, you're such a skilled playmaker and making passes. Has such a great shot. It's up there with the best of them. Him, Ryan, Jim, McCaughey, and so many others. Cable's in the draw. He wins it back on the backhand. Wade whips it in past the official. Castellucci came out to play it. It took an odd bounce into the near side corner. Foss for Team DMV. Looking for Weissman. Cable took it away. And they break it out. Black. Across the line was Barnett. Off the wall, Weissman. Has Cable with him. Dylan Weissman couldn't make it past the defenseman, Tobin, as he got laid out. A hip right into his hip as he was trying to speed past Tobin. Back on D. Glance can't keep it in. He'll have to come back for it. 6-1, Team DMV in front as we creep to the halfway mark of this game. Schaefer ahead for Weissman, has Levesque to his left, tells him to go and chase it. Tobin lost it, back to the front. Weissman's backhand try goes wide. Minthorn tried a sharp angle try. It hit the side of the cage. Glance keeps it in with the shaft of his stick. And back is Team DMV. Foss across. Barnett looks to move to the backhand. Robbie Wade stands him up. A nice defensive play there by Wade. Now Minthorn the other way. Minthorn on the backhand. Minthorn to the net. Backhand try goes wide and in front of the crease. Team AZ had numbers there. Minthorn took it to the backhand. But nobody home in the slot. Spencer across the line. Hudson Spencer turns with it at the half wall. Burr right up on him. Schaefer looking for Barnes. He gets taken off the puck from behind. Talent came back on the back check. Talent with Sarda in front, couldn't find the pass. Schaefer will high flip it out. Not enough for icing. Haven't had a whistle now in a while. Barnett carries on the near side across the red. Playing give and go. Spencer. Sticked up and out of play by Taylor. Chance Taylor, of course, of Centennial High School. Him and Logan Gibbs. Gibbs on the copper team. Taylor here on the black team. Both split time this year for Centennial, the Division I state champions in Arizona. Had a 16-4 regular season. Couldn't have been a better year when you talk about the year prior. It was a nightmare. Things went did not go their way. They really needed to find something, and they got their head coach in Caleb Drinkhouse. First-year head coach. He's been with the program. He played for the program. He was there as an assistant coach. Got the promotion to head coach and ran with it, and then some. We're going to get another penalty here. Elbowing is the call. It looks like Becker, but let's see who they're going to get. Yep. Barrett Becker to the box, elbowing the call. 2 minute power play for Team DMV. They're 1-for-2 on the man advantage so far today. That power play goal happened right here in this period. Hudson Spencer with the marker. Off the draw. Team DMV controls. Burr pressures his man in the corner of Pententi. Back in front. Sharp angle try by Scheinerman. Went off the side of the net. Scheinerman turns in the corner. We have another penalty upcoming. We'll see if Team DMV wants Arizona to just touch it. And they will. Wood will touch it. Penalty. We'll make it a 5-on-3. And that was the smart play to let Team Arizona touch it. You want as much 5-on-3 time as possible. So not only will Becker be in the box, he opens the door for his teammate and Blake Burr. The call is roughing. The officials looking over at the Team Arizona bench. 6-1 the score. Team DMV with a 5-on-3 man advantage. It's a longer conversation than usual between the officials, head coach Kenny McGinley, assistant coaches Aaron Burden and Austin Rauer. It doesn't seem like an intense conversation. But they're just deciding on exactly what they want to do. So that's the end of that. Power play, 5-on-3 for Team DMV. They knock it back. Peretti to Patenti. Peretti at the top, big slap shot save by Taylor. We mentioned it, they love to put the puck on net. Team DMV does. They've done that time and time again, looking for rebounds, for tips, any chance with the man advantage and even strength. Jensen wins the draw back. Tobin steps in, shoots, blocked down in the slot. Tesmer can't carry, rebound try. Scheinerman couldn't get all of it. Patenti on the half wall. Patenti in the circle will circle. He button hooks away. Tobin gets it right back to the top, fakes the slap shot. Patenti walks in, shoots, saved by Taylor, cleared away by Tesmer. Still a 5-on-3 for 45 more seconds. Team DMV coming up on 30 shots. Tobin in the corner. Back up to Repke. Repke drops it. Tobin gets it right back to Repke at the goal line. Back in front. Tipped in front by Clavin, but wide. Tesmer guards the front of the net on this two-man advantage for Team DMV. Clavin will circle. Back up to the top. Valco shot. Repke went wide. Back behind the net. Himmelfarb will keep it going. 5 seconds until Becker's out of the box. All the way across. Tobin looking for Repke. Becker comes out of the box. Now a 5-on-4. Himmelfarb is forced to put it back out to neutralize. 15 seconds until Blake Burr comes out of the penalty box. Tesmer will whip it all the way down. He has a hard shot. That was a hard clearing attempt. But had some frustration in there as well as they look to find Wolf. Becker has it. Rebound chance for Wolf. Diving play. Still loose in the slot and carried out by Team DMV. The penalty is over. A very strong kill for Team Black. Repke cuts to the slot. Taking off his stick. Brown 2-on-2 with Becker. Becker on the backhand, pins his man to the boards. Brown holds it at the half wall. Taken away by Team DMV. They have numbers the other way. Klavan across. Good stick by Payne to take it away from Repke. Payne drops it, looking to get it to Brown. Still loose. Becker can't hold on to it. Black curls in the corner. Looks to find a passing partner in front. Foss in the circle. Puts down Derryberry, and he looks shaken up. We're going to have a penalty against Team DMV. It's going to be a slash against Foss. Derryberry went down. It seems like it caught him in a sensitive area. Foss to the box. Team AZ to the power play for the second time today. The five-man unit they send out includes Schaefer, includes Minthorn, Barnes, Burr, and O'Sullivan. Those three with a 2D set. Schaefer wins it back. Minthorn shot blocker save. Castellucci. Slashing the call against Foss. Derryberry drew it. We'll see if he comes out on the other power play unit, as he usually is. Hopefully he's all right. Shorthanded, Team DMV looks to control. Schaefer with 3 minutes to go in period number two. Drop pass from Minthorn. He lost it. DMV the other way, shorthanded. Spencer, Black, put it wide on the back. Had the open net, but couldn't finish the job. Schaefer with Barnes. Going 2-on-4, it's gloved down. So loose, Minthorn from the slot, put it wide. Spice back behind the net. Barnes pins him. Looking in front, still loose. Castellucci comes out and just swipes it out of the slot with his big goal stick. Under a minute to go in the power play for Team Arizona. Schaefer, long pass to Brown. Burr will have to come back. The defensemen on this unit haven't even been able to get a change. Been out there for over a minute and 20 seconds. Payne, Brown, turns it over. DMV the other way. Sarda across the line. Backhand pass in front. Off the stick of Taylor. Wood can't hold it. Talent will pin it against the wall with 20 seconds to go in the man advantage. O'Sullivan ahead to Brown. Brown across the line, steps to the center. Brown puts it through into the slot. Wolf comes off the wall with it. Nick Wolf now at the top. Almost turned it over. Two DMV forwards went down. A stick goes flying. And now that stick's picked up. Power play over. Tessimer shot, save by Castellucci, who's 11 for 12 so far tonight. A nice hard shot from Tessimer. But opportunities go awry in a period that Team DMV has dominated. They've only scored one goal, which is almost a little bit shocking considering how many great opportunities they've had. All credit to Chance Taylor as he's come in and really settled down this game. Payne knocks it back off the faceoff. Derryberry down low for Brown. Connor Brown lost it. Tobin for Team DMV. For Patenti over the line. Patenti pass one. Patenti tried to get past two. Loose puck. Here goes Nick Wolf. Chased by Tobin. Wolf on the forehand, and Tobin does a good job of coming back for it. Patenti picked up the puck. Here comes Scheinerman. Over to Patenti, pass Burr. Patenti from his backside, almost put in the back of the net. Diving down on his stomach, just missed the side of the net. Scheinerman in his own end with 30 seconds to go. Patenti across the line, looking to feed Jensen in front. Payne to Wolf. Tried to drop it, Payne not onside. They've done that play a couple times this tournament. The give-and-go play between Wolf and Payne. That's how they scored their first goal against Team Midwest yesterday morning. It was Payne to Wolf to Tesmer. Put it in the back of the net. On a shot over the goalie's left hand side. Remember, just a 1 minute intermission, so don't go anywhere when the period comes to an end. Before we start period number three, Spice looking for number seven. Spice to the goal line. He'll circle. Has Repke at the top. Is D. And Masick will take it back. And that'll take it to the end of period number two. Only one goal for Team DMV in that one. It was a power play goal by Hudson Spencer. 6-1, they're in front after two. We'll be right back. The chant of DMV from the bench as we start period number three here from Plano, Texas. 6-1, DMV in front through two. They come all the way out. Burr will play it past the red line and in. Five goals in the first, one goal in the second from Team DMV. Weissman lays out his man. We've had a couple penalties as well in this game, but Team DMV has really dominated in every facet. Especially even strength here. Spice's big slap shot goes into the catching mitt of Taylor, who holds it. Told you earlier, we'll get you the times and stream links for both teams in terms of Copper and Team Black. Tomorrow, or at least later tonight, on our social media channels, Asha_hockey on Instagram, Twitter, and Facebook. Taylor makes another glove save. Right now, as it reads, it's going to be Team Copper against Team Texas. They won the tiebreaker, Arizona Copper did. So Copper and Texas will take place. That'll be at 9:30 tomorrow morning. We'll most likely be doing that game, and it all depends on the result of this one as Taylor makes another stop. In the Fort Worth division, these two teams, of course, are the last game everyone else has played. Team DMV will go to the top. They will be the second seed behind Team Idaho. That's 4-0. Team Black took Team Idaho to the brink. They took them into the shootout and lost 2-1. Team Arizona Black most likely will drop this one. They get 1-1-1, their record. And we'll see where they want to put them in terms of the scheduling for tomorrow's last day. They do it a little bit different here in terms of the scheduling with different seeds. It might be at 10 a.m., they might be at 9:30. It's all about what happens in differential and, well, math that none of us want to do. That's why they make the computer do it. This one in front, it goes past Taylor's glove. If Arizona Black drops this game, as I continue to try to figure out this math, they will move, as I said, to 1-2-1, which will stick them at seed number 5. as Taylor makes another save. They'll be at the fifth seed, which when we go back to the schedule tab and look at the potential games tomorrow, that would put them at a 12 noon start tomorrow. So possibility for a 9:30 and a noon game tomorrow, which means we can stream both. Possibility, right? 9:30 right here. However, the 12 o'clock game would be over at the other rink. So we can see our capabilities as Spencer puts it off the blocker of Taylor. It's all about, of course, how long the Copper game goes and, well, how quick and how the traffic is here on the Dallas highways and how quick we can set it up over at the other rink, which would be an interesting situation. Would be at the Tom Gagliardi rink as well, the rink that this team, or I should say the Copper team, did not play at last time. We did not see that rink last time we were there for the one game yesterday. So make sure to check out our social media channels for that and scheduling and all that. And of course, that's not set in stone. Anything I said is not confirmed unless you see it on the Dallas Stars Tournament's website or our social media accounts. As I said, Asha_hockey, Jenna Mazel does a great job running those. 6-1 DMV in front with 2.5 gone here in the third, up 33-13 in shots on goal. Each team will play one game tomorrow. It's not a playoff game unless it's both number one and two seeds, which Team Arizona Copper will be in. So you can call it some sort of a Lone Star Showcase Championship. This one's going to be holding your hand on the puck as Wood caught it and held it for a little bit too long. And he knows it. So he heads to the bench, face off outside the offensive zone. So Team Arizona Copper will be playing in the quote-unquote championship here at the Lone Star Showcase. Team Black did not have as much success. They did win earlier today, but they will play another game either way. Remember, this is a showcase of sorts. This isn't your Division I playoffs at Mullet Arena, where there's a golden stick given out. There's a trophy that looks like the Stanley Cup. You got your name on it, the whole thing. That's not what we're dealing with here. Loose puck in the slot. Brown will turn and fire it out. 4.5 gone here in the third. A 20-shot advantage for Team DMV. Payne knocks it down out of midair. Wolf with numbers the other way. Wolf has Wade. Wolf to the net. And Castellucci kept his post. Get that right leg on the post. Here they come the other way. On the break is Team DMV. Shoulder saved by Taylor. Rebound went high off of Jensen. Turning and flipping it to the blue line is Brown. Peretti turned it over and got it right back. Peretti got past one, not past two. Brown will look to make him pay. All the way across for Wolf. Payne goes down right through Main Street to Payne. Backhand try saved by Castellucci. Long pass. Scheinerman walks in. Shoot saved by Taylor. And the rebound he gobbles up. After the play, Scheinerman's stick goes flying after a slash. We'll see if they want to assess a penalty. I think they do. We can never tell with these officials. Had some shaky officiating, to say the least, today. And yes, they will deal out a penalty. Ethan Glance for that slash after the play. You're going to see Glance right in front with Scheinerman. And he just slashes his stick right down out of his hands. Power play for Team DMV. They are one for three on the day. That power play goal coming off Hudson Spencer's stick in the second period. Peretti, big slap shot, saved by Taylor, and a hold. Chance Taylor has been very good ever since he came into this game. He has saved over 10 shots. He has not allowed a goal. Mullen with 19 saves on 25 shots. And Taylor, now 11 for 11. Moving in, shooting, and another save by Taylor. As Esko Himmelfarb was moving in the slot. Esko Himmelfarb again, saved by Taylor with the right pad. Slapped and cleared out to the net. We'll see if it got a piece of the camera. We've never had that happen before throughout our entire regular season. It seems to be all right, and I hope it is. I don't think it took a direct shot, but it might have got a little bit of the netting and tied up in it. Had that happen earlier today. Yes, we're going to try to fix that, but we have two great cameras behind both nets as well.
Yeah, sorry about that.
Our main man, Ben Smith, our great producer, going to fix that. This one in front, Taylor with another nice save with the pad. Team DMV still dominating. And down and covering it is Taylor. Power play continues.
Sorry. Yeah, I just flipped it. I'll have the camera back in just a second.
The technician of Ben Smith going to work, as you can see.
Sorry, probably a little dizzying.
Some great sticking right there to the glass. He's going to try it one more time.
There we go. All good.
We'll see. It's going to connect. As you can see, a great view of the great rink here in Plano, Texas. But will it move? That's the question.
Oh, yeah.
And yes, it will. Ben Smith, smarter than smarts. It's dangerous to put an expensive camera there, to say the least. We haven't had that problem all regular season, all playoffs. But now we somehow go to another state, and it happens. Taylor with another pad stop in front. From a sharp angle, it goes wide. Knocked out of midair. Derry Berry jumps in. He takes a big hit from Tobin. And now Team DMV coming up close to 40 shots. And the camera is all right. That's probably the most important thing we're talking about here. We're down to 9:13 to go in the third period. Got to give a lot of credit to Chance Taylor and also Vinicio Castellucci, the goalie for Team DMV. 13 saves on 14 shots. Valco back in his own end. Getting it ahead. Black on the forehand, on the backhand will curl at the circle. Kicks it from his skate to his stick all the way across. They have Tobin at the top on a power play that has 10 more ticks to go. They turn it over and Levesque pokes it out. Coming out of the box is Glantz. We're back to 5-on-5 play. Team Arizona 3-for-4 on the penalty kill today. Another penalty upcoming. Or check that offside. That was a collision with Levesque and Valco as he was entering the zone. The puck just jumped off his stick. Both players okay as they went knee to knee. Schaefer wins it all the way back to Burr. Coming up on the halfway mark here in the third. Burr puts it ahead. Becker pressuring the blue line as it's put into the open corner. Spencer has one tonight, had the sixth goal on the power play for Team DMV. Taken off the puck by O'Sullivan. Schaefer now comes in. And they're trying to dig it out of that corner. Spencer trying to get it past to the blue line, but nobody home. Spice across. Wood gets on the loose puck. Wood toward the net, put it wide. Burr backs up. Schaefer kept it in for the moment. Spice to back up and get it out. He skates through center and will just chip it in. A 25-shot advantage for Team DMV. They've been dominant all tournament long. Mentioned it, no regulation losses. They lost one in overtime earlier in their four games. They will end 3-0-1 in the Fort Worth division. Make sure to check out DallasStarsTournaments.com for your scheduling needs. First shot goes wide. Peretti in the corner. Spencer, Sarda, Payne. Peretti across the blue, now across the red on the backhand. Under 7 minutes now. Take it off the stick by Brown. Payne chips it out, looking for Wolf. The alley-oop pass. Nick Wolf will backhand it in. There's a stick in the lower circle on the far side of the DMV defensive zone. Peretti to Scheinerman, trying for the give and go. Taylor puts it off the glass on the far side. Wolf can't pick it up. Now he gets the breakaway. Wolf all alone. Nick Wolf three this morning and couldn't get a shot away. What a back check from Team DMV. That was Jensen coming all the way back. Wolf doesn't pull the trigger here. He thought he was all alone, but Jensen came all the way back to lift his stick at the last moment. In a 6-1 game, a very valiant play from Jensen. Took a lot of hustle and a lot of energy to do so, and it pays off, as it looked like Wolf was all alone from the blue line in. Glance, looking for Wolf, and he does. Turned it over. Peretti gave it right back to Wolf. He flutters it ahead for Payne. Payne lost it to Peretti. Wolf gets it right back. Wolf tried to feed it across. Wade gets his stick in there. Here comes Team DMV the other way on the far side. Chesmer back on D, getting his stick in the way. Loose puck in the slot. Picked up by Payne. Trying for Wolf. Goes off the skate of Valco. Esko Himmelfarb back behind his own net. He got the scoring started in the first period. He had two in the first. Six goals, five different goal scorers for Team DMV. On the far side, Himmelfarb puts it in front. Still loose. Taylor can't gobble it up. One more centering try. Taken away. Weissman can't hold. Valco shot blocked away by Payne. Rebound try. Taylor makes the save. Chance Taylor has been excellent. 16 shots against, 16 saves as this one goes down for an icing. Face off to the left of Taylor, a 41-15 shot disparity. That was the scouting report coming in, and well, the report was right. TMB likes to put the puck on net. They've done that to both goaltenders, and Roy Moen and Chance Taylor. 4:10 to go in period number three. Weissman loses it. Levesque on it. His breakout pass looking for Cable. Knocked down is Burr. And it was not played by a high stick. Signals the officials with the safe sign. Cable for Weissman, under four now. It hits off the ceiling here, which you see the great Dallas Star green in the pillars here at the Plano Ice Rink. Most of the teams here at the Lone Star Showcase went to the Dallas Stars-Seattle Kraken game today. Stars won 3-1, and all the players got to somewhat converse and see each other outside of the hockey rink, outside of the competitive glass-centered environment. Chasing into the corner, Team DMV. Spice at the blue line, taken away from Team Arizona. Here's Barnes, his Horizon gloves. Burr puts it across for Schaefer. Backhands it to center ice, lost it to Barnett. Schaefer got it right back. He gets laid out in his own end. The pass is not connecting right now for Team Arizona. Spice was a little too quick over the line. Offside. Sparta in the circle. Team DMV can just taste it at this point. They will move up to the two seed in the Fort Worth division. Right behind Team Idaho, who's a perfect 4-0. Team DMV perfect, but also had a game go to a shootout, which takes away 1 point. So they'll be 1 point away from the number one seed in Idaho. Spice toward the net. Still loose. Taylor goes from his right to his left, and the puck comes right to him. A game that was all DMV to start. They had 2 goals in the first 3 minutes, 5 goals total in the first. Team Arizona's Brody Payne got on the board off a fortunate bounce off the DMV defenseman. And then one more goal, Hudson Spencer. Shot from the blue line goes in. That's Steven Masick. He goes high blocker on Taylor. Goal number 7 on shot number 43. Masick at the blue, winds up and fires over the blocker of Taylor. That perfect 17-for-17 saves here in the third. And the part of the second goes awry, 7-1. DMV in front. Their first goal here in the third. So Masick gets the goal. Under 2 minutes now to play. Wade walks in at the goal line. Robbie Wade taken down hard. Wood looked for a wraparound. 3-on-2 the other way for DMV with speed. Right down center ice, it's Sarda. He gets it back. Back door. And he couldn't connect with Barnett. Spencer looking for it as well. Now Barrett Becker on the backhand. Puts it on net. Castellucci with the save. Becker laid into the wall. Cable comes back. 1:25 to go in the final frame. Becker pushes his man. Talant turns it over in neutral to Becker. Becker with one too many moves, loses it at the blue line. Wood, as we creep to 60 seconds left. Patenti, pass Wood, backhand pass in front, and they score. What a shot in the final minute from Team DMV. Patenti fed the front of the net. That looked like Jensen. That finished the job. Keegan Jensen gets the goal for Team DMV. Goal number 8 on a nice play in front, and the running clock continues now with under 25 seconds to go. Now with 15, Jensen gets the goal, 8-1 DMV in front. Makes the goal differential look even better. Taylor makes the save, pushes it to the corner, and that will take us to the end of this one. The final game of round robin play is concluded. 8-1 DMV takes this one. Team Arizona Black moves to 1-2-1. Here in round robin play. Make sure to follow us on social media, Asha_hockey, Instagram, Twitter, Facebook, for all scheduling and stream links for tomorrow. We'll see you tomorrow, right back for 1 and possibly 2 more streams.